G'day, g'day, it's Tim Pachalka here. I'm the Aussie Android Dev Guy. Today's video is all about the Java Development Kit installation and configuration of said software for a Linux platform. Yes, if you're running Linux, you're in the right place. Now, do not despair if you're running a Mac or you're running a Windows machine. I have got you covered here at the Aussie Android Dev Guys channel. Click on over here for the Mac video and down here for the Windows video. And basically you can do the same thing, or we go through and follow along and do the same thing for your platform. I don't discriminate on this channel. Yes, I'm that type of guy. Moving on, today's video again, just to confirm Java Development Kit installation and configuration for Linux. Let's get to it. Firstly, let's check if there's a Java installation already present on the machine. So I'm going to go into Terminal. And I'm going to type Java space minus version. And if that came up with a version number, that would mean you had Java installed, but in this case, no Java. You can see there, it cannot find it, so we can go ahead. Now, just a note that if you haven't got Java 8, if it doesn't come up and say something like Java 1.8, I do suggest you do proceed, because Java 1.8 is definitely recommended and not earlier versions. Okay, so first things first, we're going to be using the repository set up by the Web Update 8 team for their PPA repository, which is just a shortcut to get the commands necessary to do the installation. So I'm going to type sudo add-apt-repository space PPA colon web updateteam /java. It'll be prompted for a password. Type in your password. And that's the password for your computer, by the way, not some other password. So I'm pressing enter there. You can see that it's saying press enter to continue. Once that's done, which you can see it is there now, the next step is to type sudo app-get-update. That'll chug for another 10 or 15 seconds or so. That does depend on the speed of your internet connection as well. Then the next command we're going to add is the one that does the actual installation of Java itself. And that will be pulling the files from the Oracle website. Okay, that's completed. Type in sudo space apt-get, I should say, install Oracle Java 8 installer. And that's going to ask me, are you sure you want to do that? I can just press enter, or I can type Y and press enter. And it's going to ask me to accept the license agreement. So I'm pressing enter there on that screen and moving the left arrow over to the left to say yes, I agree to their terms, their license terms. And we should find it will start downloading. Now it's a fairly chunky file. It does depend on the speed of your internet connection as to how fast, or how long rather, it will take. You can see it's about 140 megabytes or thereabouts in total. So once that's done, that will do a final installation for us. We're going to check the Java version to make sure that the Java can be seen and we've got the right version, and then we're just going to set up our environment variables and we'll be done. Okay, so now if we type Java space minus version again, remember last time we got an error, this time we've now got some success. You can see now it's showing you on the screen that Java is installed, build 1.8.0_25. That might change depending on the time that you're watching this, or when you're watching this, because obviously Java do update, or Oracle update Java on a regular basis. But my point I said earlier was you want to make sure that you are running 1.8. So if you're running an earlier version, you know, if this 1.8 was, you know, 1.7 or something like that, I do suggest you upgrade to 1.8. Okay, last thing we need to do is set up the environment variables, and thankfully that's easy as well. Type sudo space apt-get and Oracle Java 8 set default. So it's Java 8-set default. Enter. And whoops, I forgot a command there. The Java app, after the app get, I should have the word install, because that's what we want to do. And that's now set up the environment variable. So we're actually done at this point.
And that's a wrap. We're now done and dusted. We've got our Java Development Kit installed and configured. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click on the subscribe button to the left of me, and you'll be able to keep up to date with the latest videos on app development for Android and games development as and when I release them. Also, please check out the videos again a little bit further down to my left, and there's probably a video there that will take your fancy. Click on that and go straight to that video for some more Android app/games goodness. Now, speaking of content, please also leave some comments below on the video. Let me know what you thought of the video, but also, you know, perhaps more importantly, let me know what you'd like me to cover in future videos, because I want to be the number one premium resource for you for Android development tips, tricks, tutorials, and so forth. But in order to do that, I need some feedback from you to know what you'd like me to cover in future videos. So please do that. And lastly, but by no means least, drum roll please, please check out my Android development course right below me. There's a big box there. Click on that. 25 plus hours of video training teaching you, whether you're a beginner, you've never done, you know, literally a line of code before with Android apps, or you want more experience, there's something in there for everyone. Over 10,000 students have already taken that course, more signing up every day. I'd love to see you in there, so check out that page. And this is Tim Pachowka, the Aussie Android dev guy, signing off, and I'll see you in another video. Cheers for now.